Hi there, I'm Katie Worthing, reporting from the Yarmouth History Center, here to introduce you to one of our newest collections acquisitions. This is a fabulous watercolor of the Yarmouth-built bark Henry Kelsey, sailing into Marseille Harbor on November 8, 1844. This painting was done by French artist Honoré Pellegrin, who worked in Marseille, painting dozens and dozens of very similar ship portraits. And the vessel at this time in 1844 was captained by a Yarmouth man, Joshua Adams Gray. And he was part of a really large seafaring family in Yarmouth, the Drinkwater family, who had connections to many decades, almost centuries, of ship building and ship captaining in Yarmouth through the years. This painting comes to us from a local estate. The family was very supportive about seeing it come into our collection, and so was our board and members of our collections committee. We're really thrilled to have it as part of our collection at the Yarmouth History Center. One of the great things about this painting is not only that it shows us a little bit about Yarmouth shipbuilding history, but we also have a lot of archival materials about it too. So things like log books from the 1840s, original letters from the captain to his parents, back and forth from the 1840s and 50s, which really help us fill out the picture about this picture. We really can understand its context and the people whose lives were entwined with it a little bit better. There are also other collections held at the Harvard University Library and at the University of Michigan Library, and these items have all been digitized, and they too relate to this object, so we really can have an amazing array of original archival resources available to help us understand it. So looking at this watercolor, we can see Honoré Pellegrin's really typical marine painting style for the early 1800s, mid-1800s. He's really well known for painting this black bar at the bottom of the painting that identifies the ship and its captain. Here you can see it's clearly identifying Captain Joshua Gray, 1844 for the date. And it's listed as being of North Yarmouth because, of course, Yarmouth in the 1840s was known as North Yarmouth. The towns didn't split until 1849, so this is accurate for that era. The vessel's painted in a full array, showing its sails, all of the rigging. There's people on board working. You can see really clearly the American flag flying at the stern of the ship. There are another flag that shows the ship's name, and it's also labeled on the bow of the ship, Henry Kelsey. So we know very clearly that this is the Yarmouth-built bark. The painting's full of incredible details that Honoré Pellegrin included, including other vessels approaching Marseille Harbor alongside the Henry Kelsey. And there's also a big clue about the location. In the background on the right-hand side of the painting is Fort St. Jean, which is a major landmark in Marseille. This was built in 1660 by Louis XIV and really defines the harbor. And it's a little dim in this picture, but if you zoom in, you can see it clearly. So we know this is definitely Marseille. The bark Henry Kelsey was built in Yarmouth in 1842. Of course, it was North Yarmouth at the time. And it was built by Seabury and Dunham, who were a pair of shipbuilders who had established a sail loft at Union Wharf in Yarmouth. So this is right at the top of the harbor, kind of near where Yarmouth Boatyard is today, where the 295 overpass crosses. They had a sail loft there and then established their shipbuilding business. And the Henry Kelsey was one of the vessels that they built pretty early on in that run. They were in business until the later 1840s, and then each went their separate ways to other shipbuilding businesses. The original owners of the Henry Kelsey were Samuel Sweetser, Nathaniel Jenks, and Joshua Gray. Joshua Gray, of course, is identified on our watercolor as being the captain of the vessel in the early 1840s. His brother Harrison O. Gray served him as first mate on some of these early voyages. Captain Joshua Adams Gray was born in Yarmouth, North Yarmouth, in 1817, and he took to the sea quite early. There are records of him as a sailor in the early 1830s when he's just 16, sailing to New York. Some of the archival letters that we have from between him and his father recount his father encouraging him to stay in school, don't commit to the sea too early until you've had your education. I don't know that the younger Joshua was all that committed to school because he seems to have really kept to his seafaring career from that point forward. Captain Gray sailed the Henry Kelsey for several years in the early 1840s. We have log books from these journeys recounting his records, his accounts, all of the the kind of ins and outs of the various journeys that he made in the 1840s. Other captains took over the sailing of the Henry Kelsey in the late 1840s and early 1850s, and unfortunately, Captain Joshua Gray passed away in 1853. In our collection here at the Yarmouth History Center, we have several original logbooks that were kept on board the Henry Kelsey in her early voyages in the mid-1840s. We also have the logbook that was kept on the journey that brought the Henry Kelsey into Marseille, where this painting was painted. We know exactly what was happening on board the Henry Kelsey as she approached Marseille Harbor in 1844 when this painting was created. Most of the time, logbooks are pretty boring. They record weather conditions, wind speed, heading, and if the sailing is going well, there's not much to report. Interestingly, when we look at the page that shows the Henry Kelsey's arrival into Marseille, really dramatic things are happening. They are coming into harbor, there's a small ship off their bow, and the crew makes great effort to contact this small vessel and have them move out of the way. The small vessel makes no response, and the two vessels end up crashing into one another. And the logbook records this really dramatic collision. There's damage to the Henry Kelsey. They lose some of their rigging. The planks on the side of the ship are pulled off. The smaller vessel pulls off, sails away, leaving the crew of the Henry Kelsey to figure out exactly what happened, what damage has been incurred, and what needs to be repaired. Fortunately, it was minimal for the sake of the Henry Kelsey, and they were able to make it into Marseille Harbor without further incident. It's amazing to see this logbook recording this dramatic interaction that is not even hinted at in this painting that we have, which shows a really calm entry into Marseille Harbor, but of course we know other things were happening. One of the most amazing finds that I've discovered about the Henry Kelsey is an incredible letter that is preserved at the Harvard University Archive. This is a letter from Captain Joshua A. Gray back home to his parents in Yarmouth. It is dated November 1844, and he's just about to leave Marseille for his next port, but he's writing to his parents to let them know that he's there and all is well. So here we have this young captain, he's only about 26 at the time, writing home to his mom and dad saying, "It's great. I'm in Marseille. The weather is perfect. It's a beautiful place. I can't wait to come back, maybe in the spring or summer when the weather is even better." You can just feel his energy and, you know, his just great pleasure at being able to explore the world. It really gives a sense of his personality and his hope for his future. He's chosen a career that obviously gives him a lot of joy, and that really comes through in the letter. So in the letter, Captain Joshua Gray writes, "Dear parents, you will doubtless hear of my arrival at this port long before this reaches you, as I should not write but once. I delayed writing until I left here. I am now ready for sea, shall sail tomorrow morning. I hope this will all find the family well, and also my friends in good health." He goes on to talk a little bit about his good health. The voyage over was challenging, but they made it safely. He adds, "It has been the most lovely weather while here. I think in the summer it must be most delightful and a good place to improve the health of invalids." Later on in the letter, as he's closing, he writes, "1 year ago today, I sailed from home with the Henry Kelsey. It reminds me of many things then and during the past year. I shall sail tomorrow morning for Messina and hope to sail from there by the 5th of next month, and shall be at home the 1st of February. I have enjoyed myself well thus far this voyage, have a good crew and very agreeable company. Harrison," that's his brother, "is well, but does not feel like writing today. Remember, to all inquiring friends, I remain your affectionate son, Joshua A. Gray." So our next step with this painting of the Henry Kelsey is to have it conserved professionally so that it can be displayed and enjoyed in our collection for many years to come. For more information about the Yarmouth History Center, please visit www.yarmouthmehistory.org or visit us at the History Center. We're at 118 East Elm Street in Yarmouth, and we're open Tuesday through Saturday from 10 until 4.